Oh fucking yeah, dude.
What's up?
Dude, that's what's crazy is how broken his body is too. Like his, first of all, his shoulder is off of his shoulder. He literally, dude, he looks like, you know when the Terminator comes over the conveyor belt, like, dude, his arm's off.
He's where the T-1000.
It's exactly where it needs to be.
I'm so fucking, dude. I'm so excited for the fight.
When is it?
September 10th. Yeah.
Oh man.
I mean, dude, he's gonna be, I hope this doesn't occur, but he might be the first martyr of you. It's martyrdom. To take this fight's total. No, I'm saying just for your body, what's going on. It's yeah, literally love, full love of the game. It's the deepest compliment.
Who's the guy he's fighting?
Comes out.
Oh yeah.
Yeah, I hope he wins.
He's the next big thing.
But
he's really fucking people up. Although that Gilbert fight, he struggled a little.
He's not a knockout guy, though. He's kind of like a grindy into dust dude.
He's like a Khabib.
Yeah.
Like a
white Muzzy.
Yeah. He's a white Muslim.
Frightening.
Probably bites you.
I think he's Chechen. Nobody's scarier of a human being than a white Muslim.
It's true.
That whole area is terrifying, dude.
Dude, imagine.
I listened to that Black Flags book.
Imagine breaking down.
The what?
One of their little neighborhoods.
Yeah.
Knocking on a white Muzzy's door, asking for milk or gas.
I mean, first of all, I'm not going to speak for all of Muslim society, but I would imagine if we took all of them, like, yo, who could beat their wives the most without getting in trouble? They're probably, if you did like a serious Gallup poll, there's that on the top layer. You can just, like, I just beat the fuck out of my, not all, obviously, but like, there's definitely areas.
Beat their wife the most there's without definitely getting in trouble.
Must be someone with that beard, because white dudes in Philly with that beard definitely 100% hit.
If you don't have a mustache with one of those beards, you are absolutely beating the fuck out of your wife.
Yeah, and you can also think your wife's yelling at you and you're going like this, you probably get moments of clarity. You're like, I should just fucking deck this.
You're just charging up.
Like, I grew this beard. I didn't think I'd get this beard this long. I can probably deck this chick and get away.
You remember verses of the Quran that are like, women should submit. Like, well, God said it, so.
Dude.
Their poetic flair is top notch, too. Anytime they write letters, it's like, you will pay for this in blood and souls. And I'm like, holy fuck.
That Black Flag book? Yeah. Matt put me onto this. It's the best. ISIS book. So good.
Oh, yeah. You were listening to the car?
That was Francis. Shout out Francis.
How about Zarqawi writing fucking gay love letters to his fucking dude. Zarqawi is such a bitch ass. Such a bitch ass.
Your mama's boy.
Did he want those out or somebody got into his journal?
He was writing like love letters to his sister that were like real.
Oh, whoa.
Oh, that
his
was
sister.
To his sister.
Where he had a lot of time on his hands. So he was writing every other letter in different colors.
Yeah, pens, but I
drawing flowers.
Like a middle school girl.
Dude,
did he have like
nuts.
The bubbly handwriting?
It was definitely. He was sitting there going,
when you're
they fucking they're so gay.
Dude. You're hold up just waiting for a bomb to smash through.
Yeah, but he loved his mom and I think he like had a romantic entanglement with his
sister.
I don't want to ruin the guy's reputation.
I was a little bummed out that like we just drone strike these dudes.
Yeah.
But then there's a part of me that's also pretty happy about that.
Like
Jihadi John, you remember that guy? Mm-hmm. He was a British dude that went over there and was like beheading people for ISIS on camera.
Oh, really?
He got drunk.
The first guy?
He was part of the Beatles, is what they're called. There's four British dudes.
You're far ahead.
No, I just remember that. I didn't get there.
Okay.
But we drone striked him, and there's a part of me that's like, man, that guy should be tortured.
Yeah.
Like one of them's serving life in England. It's like, kill him.
Yeah.
Definitely execute. They don't do that, I guess.
Rendition. Yeah, get him somewhere.
Plus, you're making him a martyr.
Yeah, true. But
so if he's fully got the download of like militant Islam, he's going like, sweet.
Yeah.
It's death, it's martyrdom or victory, bro.
Yeah.
That's
I like the bin Laden move where you just like snip a piece off him, dump him in the ocean.
Allegedly.
Allegedly.
True.
Yeah.
But then again, most of these drone strikes are like, he's gone.
Yeah,
like,
yeah.
You're not finding a trace. He was vaporized. I looked up the Wikipedia of Jihadi John, and they're like, it was literally a perfect drone strike. No one else got hurt. He got vaporized. And yeah, it made me happy a little bit to be like, they're all like, we're martyrs. It's this devout thing. And then some guy with a computer is like, delete that guy.
I mean, also too, when you don't understand technology, like there's got to be areas of that have like way behind on tech. So they're like, what happened? It's like, dude, a missile just came out. Apparently a guy on a computer did.
Yeah. They're probably like
a guy in Arizona with like a joystick.
That was my favorite thing.
To explain that. Imagine explaining that to them though.
Yeah.
If you've just been like a shepherd, like had like a pastoral existence, and all of a sudden you're like, there's a dude all the way over there that hit a button and that guy's dead. You're probably like, your mind would spin the craziest fiction.
Also, imagine how good their speeches have to be to rally people against that.
I'm telling you, it's blood and souls. It's nothing but like the fire, of passion.
You hit a couple
but
weddings.
They're also putting like...
That's a pretty easy speech. That's a real easy speech. You hit someone's wedding. You're like, you remember that?
Yeah, he used the when they
been a couple red weddings.
What true? what was he Abu? What was the prison thing? Abu
Ghraib.
Oh, well, Abu Ghraib was the
That's when he cut off that dude's head. They talked about the American.
No, that's not Abu Ghraib.
I'm saying he brought up Abu Ghraib in that speech. He talked shit on Abu Ghraib. Yeah. He was like, "You fucking pussies, where's your fucking zeal, you motherfuckers?" And he's cut off this like entrepreneur's head. The guy Berg, who was like trying to make towers. Yeah. He was trying to make communication towers. Everybody's like,
in tech.
Get the fuck out of here. Yeah. He was a tech nut.
The production quality of the terrorist videos were fucking the best.
Bro. Yeah, they were doing good.
The cages, the remember the one where they just pulled up like a Toyota Corolla? I handcuffed him to the steering wheel, and then one guy just got on a knee with a rocket launcher.
No, I don't remember that. No one watches this.
No, that one was sick.
Oh God!
And the drowning, they dropped them in a pool, like an Olympic pool in a cage.
Really?
Because yeah. The fire one was insane.
The Jordanian pilot was bad. Put him in a cage and then had a line of gasoline to it.
Holy
so they like
shit.
And they filmed it like
it was a movie.
Yeah,
4K great movie.
HD, 1080.
Oh my God, 4K, really good. Dude.
But they're still editing.
Imagine that dude at Best Buy being like, "Mom, what are the specs on this camera? Yeah. What are you going to use it for?" "Mom, I'm shooting a film with my buddies."
A sketch?
No, they kind of the beheading videos, they kind of fucked with you. You didn't get to watch the actual like head come off.
Oh, yes.
Don't you get to watch the whole thing?
Start cutting and then cut to just holding the head.
No. You watch the American version.
No, I was dead.
They must have remade
the uncuts.
Like,
they went through the whole
thing. Oh, they must have released
that
after. So maybe it was behind a paywall. It's like they do with porn videos, you know, where they don't show it coming on her face.
Go subscribe if you want to see
like the guy's about to bust and then they cut.
Nah.
I'm about to blow up this mall. See if you want to subscribe.
Don't forget to like, subscribe, share.
And don't forget to comment down below.
About 5 rockets.
I'm about to eviscerate Jordanian intelligence. That book is honestly the best. That's one of the
really
best
good.
Lessons. Francis Ellis, shout out.
He recommended it?
He took me aside. He said, "Look, listen to this now." I said, "All right."
It's only audio. Can you get a pamphlet?
You can get the regular book.
You probably get flagged,
it's
right?
It's not Audible exclusive.
It's just the story of ISIS.
It's
not like ISIS is
recruiting
cool.
Pamphlet. No. Yeah, yeah. No. The first 10, you're in, dude.
But no way. They're making a slight. They got Salman Rushdie. They got him.
Yeah.
Yeah.
The Muslims are still firing, dude.
Yeah. They would. He just went in for like a dinner and then they cut him up, drained
him.
No,
he was giving a speech.
Yeah.
Oh, he was?
Yeah.
Yeah, you're thinking about the other journalists.
Oh, the journalists.
Yeah.
And I think people thought it was like a... I've heard people there thought it was like a theatrical performance.
How'd they
like,
get Rushdie? That just happened, right?
Yeah, he was just giving a speech and a guy started stabbing him.
No.
He was giving a speech about why he should be allowed to say Islam's violent and a radical Islamist stabbed him to death. Like, fuck you, dude.
Yeah.
No, we're not.
Oh, my God.
There's a lot of us who are peaceful.
Did he give this speech prior to and that's how they knew he was giving another one somewhere?
No, he wrote that book. No, I think he wrote the book.
Oh. Satanic Verses.
Oh, yeah. He was on the fucking list to begin with.
He's been on the list.
Iran, the state of Iran put out a fatwa on him.
Yeah, he's the fucking guy that married the hot Indian chef.
Salman Rushdie?
Padma.
Lakshmi?
Padma.
Yeah, that
Padma.
See,
that's how you
not going to be giving speeches anymore.
Dude. Yeah, she's a smoke and married. That dude's ugly as fuck.
Yeah, bro.
Right?
Married a chef?
Yeah, Padma.
Oh, wait,
Padma,
I got that actually. Right?
That's how you get the finest Indian actress.
That's how you,
that's
how you land a Bollywood star.
Yeah.
Fatwa?
Yeah.
Oh.
God. They're pretty nasty.
That's a bad boy, though. It's like...
She's like an angel marrying a fucking landlord. He's hideous. Look at this. Look at this one and two. Oh my God, it's a powerful man, dude.
No, he looks good.
Yeah, he's a powerful New York Times bestseller. Look at that guy, dude.
He looks like
pussy harder than him, dude.
He looks like a Lord of the Rings extra.
Those eyebrows point down towards the box.
He's fucking hideous.
Look at those eyes, though. Those eyes pierce your soul.
Yeah, dude.
That book money. And then look at that angel.
Yeah.
Greatest tits in the world.
Dude, he's like a Jason Bourne character.
Yeah.
He's got a fatwa on him.
Yeah.
He literally got stabbed at a convention out of like an action scene.
It was like in Pittsburgh.
Was it really?
Where'd he get stabbed?
It's always going down in Pittsburgh.
Pittsburgh's, yeah, they wild.
Getting stabbed at like an intellectual black tie event is the horniest you can get a chick. Oh my God.
Pittsburgh.
Yeah.
God.
High society, but also in danger.
High society murder. Yeah. It's fucking as hot as it gets.
It's pretty good.
For a chick?
He just put french fries in his casket.
It was in New York. Oh, okay.
Yikes. Damn, probably not that far from here.
There's no security against this fucking, with this guy? How did that happen?
I think he like lost some zhuzh in his speeches.
So he didn't have security money?
Yeah. He wrote the Satanic Verses like a decade ago.
Yeah, it was like the 80s.
So it was kind of like...
I think like 30 years.
Yeah. Really? Yeah, I think you're right, actually.
Because he was in full-on hiding for a while.
They got a ton of people associated with the book. They were killing like... the publisher. They killed.
Really?
Yeah, they got a lot of people. They got a Japanese dude. Got hit. I don't know, but that's
probably
dangerous.
RIP.
One of the partners got hit. That's a battle.
That'll
dude.
Get me activated. Did you want to get, partners you want to get my zeal going?
Yeah.
Partners go down. I'm
just
fucking
partner trying to be like, this is
partners are last. I want to start a new political party that's just Japanese people and Spanish, like Mexicans. Like, we got to come together and form a coalition.
The Japanese and the Mexicans.
Yeah.
Holy shit. Yeah, imagine that meeting.
I want to be their boss.
That would be a good party.
Look, I'm in charge. Dude,
Coronas.
They're dropping Hispanic migrant workers.
Coronas and karaoke.
Yeah, dude.
It'd be a fun party. They are dropping that. Dude, shout out Texas. Governor Abbott.
Yeah.
Just bussing the boys up to
bro.
New York and D.C. Just like, see how it is. See if you guys want to change your mind on this fucking open borders thing.
Yeah what if they're wild. What if it does rule to have like 9 million Mexicans?
Yeah, they're bussing them back.
Oh, they're bussing them back?
Yeah.
They're bussing with the boys.
They're getting back on the bus.
This is good for a new bus tour.
I might outfit a pickup truck and just be like, follow me if you want to live. And just fucking just start a contracting company. Follow me. It's the only way. Come on.
Dude,
hop in my Dodge Durango. We're going to Home Depot now. We got to demolish this wall.
Dude, Megabus has to be killing it.
Yeah, 100%.
Omega bus got government contract. Got subsidized.
Going back and forth between Texas and New York.
Chinese casino bus. You ever jump on one of those? Woo! That's a ride.
Are they sending it back?
the Fungwa bus.
Yeah, the Fungwa. Like it goes from.
I think it got discontinued.
The Greyhound in Center City all the way to AC. I took it once. Me and like fucking 90-year-old Koreans.
You took the Fungwa to AC?
Smoking on it.
Where do they let you
off? They're fucking lawless. They let you off at like the entry point at AC. And these little munchkins
jump out before it goes into the water.
Oh, still
the bus driver
butts.
Hopped out and starts selling your body in Atlantic City.
They're fucking nuts. They don't buy any drinks. They're it's like a fucking bus full of... I don't want to get into it.
They can only have two.
I don't want to get into it.
Yeah, they only have two.
Yeah.
But yeah, dude, it's so funny to think about Texas and New York just playing Pong with Latinos. Just No, we turned it off.
You got to lose a few of them on the way, right? I mean, you can't even keep track of like fifth graders at the zoo.
Well, that was
There's got to be a couple left behind.
The funny Governor Abbott speech was like, they're totally allowed to get off the bus, just not in Texas.
Yeah.
It's like it stops at rest stops all over the place. They can get off wherever they want.
That's Con Air, dude.
Yeah.
That is Con Air.
Is there like a fat lady with a whistle around her neck counting them? You know what I mean?
It's funny because like it's funny because they just really want to work really badly too.
They're like, dude, if you're gonna solve it,
I'll be honest, these bus rides are probably pretty nice for them.
Yeah.
True. You just walked AC. For fucking the entire Central America. Now you're just AC'd out, sitting on a bus. Like,
yes.
Things are going well. They're definitely getting snacks.
Well, they're bringing out now. They're revamping the whatchamacallit, like the border family separation thing, like the colonies they had.
They're bringing it back.
They're bringing that back with a vengeance.
Really?
Yeah, Biden fucked up on gas. Now, like, remember those fucking kids in cages? They're bringing that up big time now.
Really?
Yeah, that's going to be the new thing.
The kids are still in cages?
People are now, again, outraged.
Are they?
Didn't Biden's brother build those cages?
I think so. I think it was
contracted to Biden's brother.
No way.
Hey, Chris.
Is the cage man.
I saw a guy. I saw a guy today with a Biden Harris sticker.
Dude, that was so crazy.
Yeah.
Dude, I saw a guy park in a parking lot with a Biden Harris sticker, and there was a part I was like 30% compelled to go up to him, like, dude, you like, do you really fucking like that? Did you really see those guys and be like, we're gonna turn this
There's
around?
No yeah. way.
That's how you
felt. Out of your mind. What?
You love Biden Harris.
No, I was voting against Trump. I wasn't putting That's Biden such a Harris.
Chick move.
But it's
That's
so
girl
funny.
Stuff.
It's so funny though to be like, right, we need personalityless robots to fix our country. It's people are like, we got to grow up and realize we need personalityless robots who are completely paid for by corporations and fixes. It's bullshit.
Yeah.
That's why I saw that guy's sticker. I almost literally, he was a doctor.
Should have tackled him.
I almost walked up to him like,
should've
dude,
with the Nate.
Take that shit off.
That'll fuck somebody up on the street.
If I turn my back to him,
he slaps you.
He's like, I'm calling the cops. And I was like,
now that's how you strengthen the Biden coalition.
Dude, you listen to Black Flags. That was a complete fuck up in Iraq.
Yeah.
There are people, apparently intelligent people are like, dude, the Iraqis are not our enemy. There's an insurgency. And they were like, dude, shut
Cheney was
the
like,
fuck up.
Yeah, they
dude.
Are.
Yeah. He's like, no, we're
gonna, definitely that.
We're going to completely destroy the enemy. We destroyed Iraq in like 5 seconds.
Yeah.
Completely dismantled their military and their government like very quickly. And then terrorists just attacked.
Yeah. I always thought the way that they tore down Saddam's statue was kind of lame.
Some say it was staged. I won't say who told me that on my
a
drive
lot of people
up.
Said it was staged.
Yeah.
Yeah. When it happened, there were Arabs that were like, these guys aren't Iraqi.
That's even worse.
They were like, these guys aren't Iraqi.
They just like
they thought
bent
they bust
it.
Them. They thought they yep. ponged them in.
They
sure. I was gonna say that, yeah.
I mean, imagine if it was like New York and it was just clearly a bunch of people from
Indiana,
Texas. Yeah. It'd be like, that's not how these aren't New York. Like,
yeah,
that's not the Bronx.
Yeah,
yeah. That book
that's not
says
how we tear down statues.
A lot of people in Iraq hated those guys. They were just like, America sucks, dude.
Yeah,
they were pissed because they had no idea. It's like they all of a sudden the government gets taken out, and then like they were getting like hospitals blown up, and they were just like, this is the Americans.
Yeah.
What's going on with Russia? Are they still...
I think they're trying to
fight.
We
don't get updates anymore.
It's kind of embarrassing that war is taking this long for them to beat Ukraine.
Yeah.
Ukraine's like a...
Well, we keep giving Ukraine goodies, right?
Yeah.
We're giving Ukraine them goodies.
Good we stuff. Got a recession. We need to start giving them...
Amazon's delivering some goodies. $240
billion.
Yeah. Oh, we also might be like spying in on the Kremlin with like some weird holographic spy. The technology is probably crazy right
a
now.
Holograph spy?
Probably.
Is this a Roomba?
Dude, turn it around. He's got to go in the fucking... He's got to go in the cafe. Just sitting there. He's giving a message to a corner.
That'd be funny if all like Starbucks baristas were spies.
I want to hear Chris do the robot again.
Yeah, let me hear that.
You're an act out guy now.
Big physical comedy.
I better see those act outs this weekend.
Yeah, dude.
I want to see it.
I'll bring it. I'll bring the energy.
Yeah.
That dude, I thought about that. Like, I should just go all energy. What the fuck is up, Chicago?
Yeah.
Oh, man.
I love you.
Fuck.
Yeah, that was good.
Okay, dude.
Oh, comments intro?
That was the funniest fucking thing. That was
just full Stevie Janowski, dude. He was Stevie. He was
when
like,
you, them, y'all can't hear you.
When you said that,
he did not do
this. Just got to like my best friends.
Yeah, yeah. Oh, you didn't hear this?
No.
So,
I don't know if I want to hear this.
When you did the Janowski, I leaned back against a pole. And went, oh,
he was Janowski.
God, where was
so
this?
Funny.
So we needed.
I was there.
You were lounging in the green room, I think.
You were probably dry
no,
humping.
I think what it was, show? It was second show. I think you had. I think you left, right?
You were dry humping.
Oh, like this was it? Yeah.
At Killian Keefe's,
yeah,
the
yeah,
second
yeah,
show.
Yeah, I left.
So we needed someone. Wait, what was he dry humping?
I fucking missed this.
You're upstairs dry humping. We needed.
I had to leave though.
Yeah, heavy petting, mutual petting. We needed.
I had to go home and jerk off from it.
Mine?
No, I'm kidding.
We wanted to masturbate.
We all wanted to masturbate.
We all wanted to masturbate.
How about John calling out my fucking girl? Great. I don't know where John's like, Tommy, what do you say about me? And like,
he
was like,
he brought a girl. She's got a fucking accent.
Of course she doesn't.
Of course she doesn't. She doesn't have an accent. Yeah, John is all a tan person.
John's like, he's got new girls like Ubers. I'm fucking holding the girl in the shadows like this. It was literally like a minute before that. She like looked back. She's like, I'm having so much fun. I was like, yeah, my friends rule. And then McKee was like, he gets girls through like Uber. He's got a new one. And I was like, Jesus Christ. And I was whispering to her in her ear. I was like, no, I do not.
I didn't hear that part.
Part of the accent.
Yeah, the next line, he's like, yeah, she's got an accent. Of course, she looks like she's got an accent.
She looks like fucking Catherine Zeta-Jones. Yeah,
as soon as they said accent, I was like,
I heard her talk. I talked. I'm like, hi, how are you?
She's right.
Yeah, I heard that.
He was right. In her face looked like she was about to deliver a fucking a speech, like the wife of the Mexican president.
So we needed. John was like, "Who do we have to host, like to open the show that could do high energy?" I was like, "I don't think we have one friend."
Connor,
I could have done it.
And I was like, "O'Connor can do the screaming."
That is O'Connor can do the intro. Dude.
Oh yeah.
So the first
were you mocking yourself?
No, first show was good. First show was like, you ready?
Full tilt. Yeah,
no, he had a couple cocktails.
Yeah.
We all did. That second show was out of control.
I was blacked out.
Second show was nuts. But the intro is like, Philadelphia, are you ready?
Oh my God.
The first
it's
intro.
On tape.
And he goes, I'm giving up for you. These guys are like my best friends.
Oh my God, dude. That was embarrassing.
I thought it was you doing a voice backstage.
I cut that.
I thought
you
said
it was dry humping in the group.
It's so good.
Fucking embarrassing.
At least that wasn't on tape.
Hold on, that's what you think.
You're not a fucking Uber driver. You're not a fucking Uber
driver. We got the CCTV from the.
God damn, those green rooms, the locusts were swarming.
They were.
Holy shit.
Fucking Nate and Lemaire, as soon as they walk in, just start eating. I'm like, give it a fucking minute, you fatties.
Bro, it was.
No, that pizza needed to get got.
Somebody needed to do it. There was Lorenzo's, one slice missing. I looked around the room. I was like, definitely those two.
Yeah.
Sure enough.
Lorenzo's pizza is so
bad.
There were so many people.
It's so. You got to roll it up like
it
a fucking.
I mean, the size like is not homie. Even. The size is an attempt to make up for how shitty it tastes.
Well, the sauce is a no
garbage go. Pizza. Yeah. They probably import grease from other pizza and dump it on top. It's so fucking greasy.
It's so bad. If it's not like scalding hot, if it's not burning your mouth so you can't taste it, it's
just wet.
Yeah.
It's cold, wet. Although, pizza, a slice that's this big.
Dude, we learned. Ridiculous. My cousin Ajax has a technique for eating pizza one bite. He does, obviously, the fold. Everyone knows that. Yeah. Tucks the corner of the slice up.
I
into
like
it.
That move.
Yeah,
it is nice.
Pretty nice. One slice domino. He's one slice, one bite kid on a domino slice. Dynamos.
You guys hit Dynamos late night, didn't you?
Yeah, it was.
I
really,
saw that Dynamos.
So
bro.
Good. I
Dynamos.
Had Dynamos.
It looked like K&A.
They brought like eight boxes after the show.
Straight up, the Dynamos handmade pie is unbelievable.
Yeah, it was good. Dude, I haven't had Domino's in years.
What's it called? Hand?
Ham? No, they claim to revamped.
Whatever.
They revamped their whole recipe.
But the Okame, you got a big debate coming up.
With who?
Oh, no. A big what?
He's got a debate.
With who?
Jeff? Oh, you said yes.
Yeah, I told you to say yes.
It's not a debate.
So did I.
It's definitely a debate. Why? What does he want to? Why? Who is this? Why is he reaching out to you?
Did you watch any of his content?
No.
Who is this? Jesse Lee Peterson? JLP's going to debate
you?
I don't know. It could be people goofing. But I responded to the emails like,
ask him about his allegations
show.
Of being a child molester.
I know.
Yeah,
dude.
Yeah, he's gay.
He's gay.
That
doesn't mean you fuck kids.
No, no. But he not only is he gay, but he like reaches out to young men and like is
That's
like.
That's you, dude. He's trying to fuck you.
Maybe.
He's a gay black conservative?
Yeah.
He's going to torture you, dude.
I know.
Allegedly deeply closeted black conservative.
Dude, and he's legend of the
redundant.
Drunken master level like. Debater.
He fucks people up?
Yeah.
Nice.
I don't know. I've seen him debate. He's more of a repetitive type dude.
But you
so he's black.
No.
I didn't say that. He never raises his voice.
He never raises his voice. He just repeats the question.
That's the black style of arguing.
He calls you a child of the lies.
It's always.
Yeah. Scream repeat. Yeah. Step into someone's
face. I told you many times.
What you said. And then the next move is there's no diffusing. You're going to get hit in the fucking face.
It's reality TV argument. It's
every
nine
time.
Episodes of Flavor of Love. It's literally the whole time.
Once you move to protect the body shots.
It's coming.
So how did JLP, how does Camp reach out to you?
I got an email from a guy that says he's the producer and they wanted to interview me.
What do they want? What do they want to argue on?
I don't know.
The producer reached out to the O Conn man.
He didn't say it was a debate.
He's got to give you a heads up. It's like a
debate. It's definitely a debate.
That would be crazy to reach out
so
to.
So you've
me
been
for
watching a lot of JLP.
Why you? That's, I don't so understand.
That's what I'm saying. I think it's,
I'm not being me. I hope that doesn't sound like I'm being a dick.
No.
But just out of nowhere,
he's
being
attracted
like
to him.
Chris O'Connor.
I could see JLP having a bone to pick.
Mm-hmm.
Definitely. He's probably heard. He's probably heard you rant on behalf of Kamala Harris. You love Kamala Harris.
Dude,
you think she's the right choice.
Let JLP do the work.
JLP's going to be, this is training. You better, you can't beat me. Good luck.
No.
The gay black pedophile, he's going to he's going to fucking kill you.
Dude, he will kill
the gay Christian black.
There's no question. You can't beat War Mode.
Dude.
He's,
I'll go with you.
He's better than War Mode.
I mean,
I don't mean like
have you been watching a lot of his content?
What?
Have you been watching a lot of JLP?
No, I just watched one. I had seen him do stuff like years ago and was like, who the fuck is this guy?
Yeah.
And then I watched some stuff last night and it was just like,
his arguments, he just grabs college students. He's like, you think girls should have penises? Oh, that's interesting. Why?
Is that how he talks? He talks like Carmen with a dick in his ass?
Yes.
That rules,
and then
dude.
He just goes, oh, that's how interesting. Tell me, okay, well, I don't see that. I don't see that at all.
He'll even hit you with an even more vague question. He's like, so are you, what do you think of war? And you're like,
this is going to be a clash, dude. This is how you argue. This is exactly how you argue.
This is also my nightmare. I would be so bad. Oh. I'm so bad with shit like this, where a guy asks me a serious question, and I'll be like, are you fucking with me right now? Like, and then I'll just start making fun. I could never debate, dude.
Who was I just talking to about?
He'll do a thing where you're like, if a black guy robbed you at gunpoint, what would you do?
Would you say it?
It's funny, Tom, you roundabout described thinking. You're like, not a fan of that whole thinking stuff.
Yeah, exactly, dude.
Yeah, oh, comment. You're good at that argument. Like, start an argument. And then
you gotta
then
see.
Switch.
He will. He
dude,
will, yeah.
During the Leon
he
Edwards fight, how about that argument?
He's white. This straight is one of Leon greatest, Edwards.
This is
I never switch.
Quintessential O Conn man. We're watching Leon Edwards versus Usman fight. At one point, Usman's got his back.
We must
say
first,
cage,
Shane.
And his knee. He's holding Leon like this, so
his knee's
right
there
here.
For the taking. Dude.
Leon's holding to not get choked.
Just a knee punch.
Chris goes, "Why doesn't he punch the inside of his knee?" I was like. He's like, they haven't thought of it yet. I was like, that's why they haven't done it. He's like, it's a new sport.
No,
they haven't come
it,
up with it yet.
They don't think it can
I was
be
like,
done.
It's a new sport. It's literally fighting to the death. This sport's ancient.
You got all your weight on that leg, dude. Someone hits the side of that.
Dude, you would have to hit me 100 times or lock me.
Also, you have no, you're laying down.
Yeah.
You have no.
No, he's on
his
knees.
He's holding his hand so that he doesn't get choked.
Yeah, he's cutting
as soon
off
as he lets go of his hand,
he's
fucking
go.
Choked. He's
let
done.
Go to try to give him a dead
you
leg.
Reach the
both
knee.
Are adrenaline. Well, first, both are adrenaline. They're at like 100 out of 100. Like, I'm going to punch the fat of his thigh.
You see these guys
yeah,
get
yeah,
leg
right
kicked.
The they
see, yeah, right, right. The leg kick is so much more powerful
the leg
than the
kick.
Punch.
You're more of a Krav Maga guy. You're like pressure points.
I'm just saying. Someone's got to look into it.
Relent. Just
you're saying like,
yeah. I was drunk. Obviously, that was stupid.
It's all whiskey, dude. When
but
he gets whiskey,
dude.
He wants to fight you in any way possible. He was losing four. Yeah. Yeah, no. I am dick. Look, we're both a little whiskey on sometimes.
Stuff Island's about to get going.
Has ever completely derailed due to like just whiskey intake?
Yeah, both of us?
Yes. Yeah, an episode?
Yeah.
No, what episode?
Oh, not an episode. No.
No, tell me you had to take.
Once the slate closes, you guys are like, that's enough.
Tommy hit mushrooms hard too hard once and had stuff.
I just
out.
Skedaddled.
That was very funny.
That's very funny.
That was funny.
But no, the whiskey. I've never seen you guys derail on whiskey on a show.
In
but
fact, the only
time
I was drunk,
I've seen Oculus derail off whiskey quite a bit.
Did you ever bump Oculi?
What?
No. What the fuck you doing out there? No.
Follow the rules. Follow the
rules. Fuck you. I'm not following the rules.
No, he goes in the kitchen.
Fuck. Yeah, coming home and just being, I'd come home from a show, they'd be playing Oculus. I'd be like, yo, who's got more kills right now? And it was Tommy. Tommy typically had more kills. And then Chris would be like, but I gotta, you know, I'm the one calling the shots, running
Tommy,
point.
Tommy would get so shit-faced. And that, he had no idea
what. Why do like, do this sober? It's gay shit.
We played this map.
So you played this map. You up liquid courage for the battlefield.
Yeah. I was shit-faced, too. I was shit-faced, too. But
this dude's eating banana smoothies. I'm getting liquored up so I can enjoy it.
Chris is bettering himself, and it sucks. Chris is becoming a good person. It's about as fucking lame as it gets. All right.
There's no excuse.
I hate it.
We had 600 hours put in on this board, and Tommy still didn't know anywhere besides the one roof he liked to shoot from.
Yeah.
And he would just stand up there.
That's where the health is. That's where the gun is, you know, the ammo. I get a little hiding behind.
And
he'd be like,
so here's the plan. I'm going to stand upstairs and shoot, and you guard the stairs. It's like,
no, I didn't.
Guard the stairs. There's
every play.
No.
So your boots on the ground.
Yeah.
No, I would
get bored and I would go boots on the ground.
And then he goes to the middle of town and gets shot.
Somebody kill me over here.
I'm hearing all you fucking idiots trying to do my voice.
Double time it back to the hotel to pick up Tommy.
I would go medical back.
And they'd be like yelling at each other. Like, all you could see is them with the Oculus. It's like, what the fuck? What happened? I'm just reaching. It's so fucking funny.
Also, an hour with that fucking headset on, sweating your dick off.
Sweating and shit face.
Yelling at each other.
Oh my God.
It's like doing three podcasts in a row.
Start sobering
like,
up halfway
so
through
tired.
The battle. It's the most fun. No. It's the most fun thing in the world.
Yeah. That's why I'm off screen.
Drink through the Oculus.
I take it off.
He'd lift the mask up. And then he'd see me. He didn't know I'd be sitting there. He'd be like, Jesus Christ, he's just come in.
Get out of here.
He loves coming in real quiet and just stalking us.
Dude, it's going to be so funny when they have the metaverse. They're like it's going to be like, I'm going to see a guy being like, faggot.
What is the metaverse?
The podcast sucks. It's just a guy now. Like, the podcast is fucking low energy these days. Like, dude, get out of my fucking house. Get out of my cyber house.
Like, dude,
you're schizophrenia, you dumbass. I'm like, ugh.
The metaverse is like when we would try to go watch like a Sixers game that one
time.
Yeah.
You go in that one building, you sit down next to strangers.
Yeah, Zuck got slammed. He put out his own avatar and people were like, that looks like fucking 90s graphics, you dumbass. And he was like, oh, it's a fucking test. Whatever. Yeah, he got slammed. They withdrew it. Now they're drawing. They want to get better graphics. They need a better Zuck for the Zuckerverse or whatever.
The metaverse is fun. I was in the metaverse once.
Were you in the metaverse?
I was in the metaverse. And
I was did you get the download in the metaverse?
What?
You got the download?
Yeah, dude.
I was like, dude, what are you doing?
Just putting a headset on and just going around the strangers all day. Dude, sober? Dude, that is the craziest fucking thing.
Yeah, I was hanging out.
You were not sober for this.
No, I was.
Really?
Dude.
Wait, how did you get in the metaverse?
This was a
this
late
put
night.
On the giving Oculus, me anxiety. Dude.
It's going to get everyone, bro. It's going to get everyone. We're all laughing. Everyone's going to be in the metaverse.
I fucking will. I promise you.
Yes. You'll get in there.
Yes, you will.
They got golf there?
Meet horny. Meet horny singles. You're going to meet horny singles.
You're going to meet a lot of.
Is there a gym and a bar? I'm in.
Yeah.
It's literally the only reason I got the
horny
fucking
mature singles. That was his joke, by the way.
Yeah. No, I was in the metaverse.
It all belongs to the metaverse at this point.
At this point, horny singles are in your area. You're going to find them.
Wait a second. That's a good point. There's it's going to be a dating
thing. You're going to get to go show
dating,
me.
Metaverse dating.
Yeah. Is it, do you have to build an avatar? Or is it just like.
Yeah, build an avatar.
Yeah.
You have a guy.
They can be catfishing. It could be a beefy broad.
Yeah, does it matter the metaverse,
bro? Kakua could be in there.
Yeah. You probably just take a picture of yourself from straight on and both sides and they'll just do it for you.
I like that better.
Yeah. People will be able to church up some avatars. But again, does it matter? You're in the metaverse.
Yeah. You're going to have to get
clothes. The point
you're
is
fuck
to meet
guys
him.
You're going to have to dress like
you
that
can meet
guy,
him in real
sure.
life.
Is right? that the point?
You meet him in the metaverse, you could say and do whatever you want. You're in your little cartoon pants, right?
Yeah.
You get real confident. You're saying things you wouldn't on a street in a coffee shop. You get the bra on your couch real quick.
You think people are going to be in there being like, Hitler had a tough economic situation.
No, I would never approach a girl on the street. I would never do it like Gerben does, you know?
Yeah, you'd never be a pickup artist.
Yeah,
like
I
Gerbs.
Can never say, God, you look amazing.
Peacocking,
I just want to stop
telling
you.
Telling an ice-breaking joke like Gerben's does.
Dude.
Chris did it one He's time. He said it was very successful.
Dude. Yeah, it works.
What? You did. You
in real life? I mean, it's low percentage, but you get one.
What happened?
You just walk up to people and you're like, hey.
Holy shit.
They go into flight or fight and they just freeze and say, yes.
So they feel safe.
No. There's a whole. Gerben taught me.
When did this happen?
Gerben taught me all about
You never told me you were out dating like this?
Well, Gerben couldn't do it by himself.
You and Gerben went out.
Tell the story.
Holy shit. He's trying. I keep talking. My bad.
Gerben was struggling on the apps, and he was like, I need people to like meet me in person. Yeah, so desolate. He was watching all this like day game stuff. And then he was going out. He would go out and do it. He would just walk around by himself and wasn't able to like.
Is that when he's listening to Coach Corey Wayne?
I think so. Yeah, yeah.
Yeah. Dude, he's the fun. I was talking to him about that thing. He might be the funniest dude in the world.
He is the funniest dude ever.
So fucking. I was in tears. He was just telling me.
His girlfriend's hot.
Yeah.
That was fun.
I didn't meet his girlfriend.
Gerben's got a hot girlfriend.
Oh, yeah.
Yeah.
A beaut.
And it was very fun to be like, Gerben's nice. And he's like. There's no shut the fuck up. He's just fully like, yeah.
You just tell me a regular story. I'm like, this is the funniest thing I've ever heard.
Gerby's?
Yeah.
Good.
So you and Gerby's went out pickup artist shit?
Yeah. Eventually he was like, will you just walk next to me?
And you guys were in formation.
Yeah. Yeah. We locked arms. No, so we were so I was like, yeah, I'll go with you.
What was the venue?
We were walking all around like Center City, Rittenhouse. And
where were you guys trying to bounce them to?
What do you mean? You can't.
So you guys were not even in a place. You guys were just out about and
just
about.
Walking around. Yeah. And then eventually, like, Gerben wasn't doing
psycho
it.
Psycho shit.
It is. It's crazy.
I was helping a friend.
No, you're doing a good. You did the right thing. You did
that's
the right
psycho
thing.
Shit.
That's not psycho shit.
You did the right thing.
Come on. I like
you think he did the right thing?
Yes, dude. Helping his friend get pussy?
Yeah.
Dude, help your
boy
get pussy.
This is not how you do it. You don't walk around Center City in broad daylight.
What else can I do?
Go to a bar or something.
He wasn't drinking, I don't think, at the time.
Yeah, dude.
Just get a fucking...
Doing this sober, dude.
He didn't want a bar fly. He wanted a fucking... A babe.
He wanted a girl that's going to say yes to fucking on the street.
Yeah.
Fucking.
No. They're just trying to... You don't fuck on the street.
Just to have an interesting conversation.
You're just walking up to a woman like, hello, I'd like to hang out with...
Yes.
That's fucking...
Yeah, crazy. I mean, it's
scary, dude. And these two walk... O'Connor and Gerben walking together.
I mean,
already on Saturday.
I know.
You're not wrong in that this is a wildly outlandish thing.
It's crazy.
It's insane.
Psychotic shit.
Wait till you hear the results.
But...
All right, yeah.
But... You did the right thing.
Yeah, of course. Dude, my friend needs help. I'm stepping in. I'll do whatever I need.
You were trying to get some pussy yourself.
He told me.
Well, this is what...
Yeah. Mr. fucking...
I'm going
what a philanthropist. No.
So, well, if you help your friend raid a village, obviously.
Yeah. Dude, I would do... Yeah. I'd do anything.
Well, Frank, you know, tell good stuff.
I'd do anything. So, we were walking around, and he wasn't, like, doing it. And so, I was like, I'll do it. Figuring it would be a disaster, but at least, you know,
break the ice.
Yeah, now he has to do it if I do it.
What were you wearing?
I don't, you know, my usual.
Come on,
you remember exactly what you were wearing.
What the fuck are you talking about?
I was probably wearing an Irish jersey.
Same thing I'm always wearing.
Shorts way too long, beyond his
fair
knees.
You're wearing like regular
long
stuff.
Socks and high school basketball shoes.
If you say something that annoys me. Chris, shorts way too long. Chris goes.
So you're just regular, any other day, you're dressed up like whatever. Not a tiny bit of pep in the outfit. Just
you didn't try to dress up because you knew you were going
to No, I wasn't
go.
In the mirror doing my hair.
I didn't say that.
To the podcast.
I mean, he's taking shots of time.
He's in a person.
He's funny.
Hey, I mean, there's days where I'm
does
like,
does your shirt match the couch? I just went out there to help my friend.
But I'm saying, those days, was it khaki shorts
over
gym? I
fucking punched the clock.
You did the right thing.
I got out there.
All right, we're sorry.
What a hard hat and a lunch pail.
We're sorry.
And I went to work.
All I'm asking is, did you maybe wear khaki shorts instead of gym shorts?
No, I don't think you knew that you were going to do that question.
I had no idea. I was supporting him.
So you guys
have three outfits anyway. It was probably
It's probably like a free flyer shirt that was on the seat.
Yeah, you got it on the Chinese bus.
Definitely.
So you make the approach. You're like, Gerb, stand back.
Yeah, well, he was breaking it down for me that you go up and you just say, hey, I saw you back there. Thought you looked cute. My name's Chris. And you have to like stand in a place where you're giving them like exits. Like you never swing the gate closed. You never like close them off from the direction they're heading, all this stuff.
Yeah. So don't emerge like out of a bush.
Don't stay in the bush.
You gotta peek your head back.
No, don't tackle them while they're jogging. Yeah. Definitely not.
Yeah, but I wonder if these same girls, saw, like, we're walking back from where they're coming and saw YouTube predators out talking to other girls. Like, yeah. I'd be like, these guys, what are these, there solicitors?
Was, yeah. There was a definite chance of that.
It's like, yeah, seeing that killer shit with the fake basketball team. He's trying to get money. Yeah. Like, I already saw you doing that to somebody else.
She walked up. He said, I run a modeling agency.
I'm a photographer.
You might as well shoot some stuff real
quick. Yeah. No, and then, like, you know, a lot of people would be like, oh, sorry, I'm, like, busy, or like, they're like, ah, I don't have time, or they'd be like, I have a boyfriend, or something like that. But, like, I would say 25% of the time, you'd get, like, a number.
How many girls did you do this to?
Not that many. Probably, like, 10.
Okay.
That's decent, dude.
It's very decent.
That's a lot.
And you said
both of you combined did 10 or individually?
Yeah, I'm not sure. I'm not sure if I saw Gerben ever do one.
Gerben didn't do it at all.
Yeah, dude, after you do it twice, you just stop giving a fuck. Yeah. Like, you're just like, well, whatever, dude.
So you got like three numbers, four numbers?
Yeah.
Dude,
I went on a date. I went on a date with two.
How'd the date go?
See, why did you stop doing this?
No.
We got a bro around a story. What? You and I. I'll try it with you.
Yeah,
bro. No,
I'll bitch out of me. Yeah.
You'd be so good. What are you talking about?
I don't know, man. I can't even talk to a girl at like a gym. I feel weird because I know they're getting accosted all the time. If I'm going to talk to one, it's going to be a top shelf one. You know what I mean? Somebody I got to get a little stool to get. This
spot's going to be. How do you break combo with Chris, that? How do you do
sorry,
that?
Sorry, Chris just hit me with the gym from the office look. What are you doing? Because if I got to talk to a girl, it's top shelf. He's like, the camera.
I don't like you on
nervous.
This side.
You're too nervous to do it. Why don't you start off with something?
Yeah, get some dogs.
True. That's what the Kama Sutra says to do.
Really?
The Sutra says to practice on like less desirable lovers.
Yeah. Well, then I got to go take three meat.
That's how you learn how to like fuck a chick with like a
straight down.
Like to put your dick in your own butt while you're pulling your
every last you're under no obligation to call them. True. Just get a number.
That's awesome.
Yeah.
Yeah, it's very successful numbers. Were you so successful? Gerben's like, I can't. I don't want to do it.
No. It's like, the thing is, you know, you feel sad when someone's like, yeah, no, you know.
Yeah.
But eventually, it's like stand up where it's like bombing. You're like, that sucked, but also I'll do it again. I'll get it. Yeah.
I'm gonna somehow fuck a fat chick out of this.
I'm gonna get chlamydia.
Yeah, I'm gonna find the open mic of women today.
Yeah, just in Philadelphia, cold calling pussy.
Yeah, I think Gerben did it once or twice.
Did he get any? Did he have any success that day?
Nah.
I can't imagine.
It was like Gerby's on the cold call. It was over the course of like three or four days.
What? A Gerby's cold call must be like, well, hello, I'm Steven. I noticed that you were pretty. That must be fucking terrifying. These girls are accosting women walking down the street.
It's so funny. We were laughing so hard at each other because when it would go bad, the walk back to the friend.
It's kind of
fun. The walk, the meandering walk. Back to the friend. The
how'd it go?
She wasn't. Dude, she had a fucking bitch. She was a lesbian. Fucking ton of lesbians.
Yeah, I could smell her breath anyway.
Yeah.
Fucking pig.
Disgusting.
Dude, you know, I ran into Artie P. does this for a living.
Dude, he is.
Who?
Let me tell you something. He's the fucking man.
He's a coach. He's a
hitch?
Cold approach coach. He's a hitch, dude.
Dude, he's a hitch. Know, and not Artie, only that, he's the most charismatic. Even when he talks to me, I'm like, I get it. His energy is so aligned with like whatever you're talking about. He just was just in Spain and Portugal or whatever the fuck. And he's like, I was like, how'd you do it? He's like, I did well. Like he's just, he does it all day. He just approaches women talking to him and he just fucking knocks it out of the park, dude. Number after number after number. It's nuts. And if you talk to him, he's so calm.
Yeah, he's cool.
Smile, complimentary. He's a great guy.
Damn. Yeah, he's the man.
It's a fucking art. Fucking art.
It's putting out the good energy.
Yeah, I don't like it.
that's not for me. I don't. But
I like Artie a lot. I think he's a man, but I don't love dudes walking around being like, I saw you. You're like having a game plan about how you're
going to. I don't know. He doesn't do it like that.
I know, but the whole coaching, I don't know.
It's weird.
I don't like that stuff.
It's more
like
the philosophy.
I really hate it.
I think the majority of people heavily dislike.
Well, it's manipulative. It's like, here's how I'm gonna trick this person. I gotta make sure they have exits so they're comfortable, so that I can eventually fuck them. It's fucking psycho.
Yeah, I know. It is dehumanizing.
There's no question.
It's dehumanizing to where it's like you're a target.
I mean,
Yeah,
you're strategizing.
That's how I approach dating, though, forever. Well, not like that, but I would just meet a girl. I'm like,
Well, yeah, I mean, you're an autopilot of just like, true. You're trying to make her happy, but you're not like, I'm going to go in there. I'm going to agree with what she says. I'm going to try to make her comfortable. No. That's my plan. for this dinner. It's like, that's fucking nuts.
Well, this is for people that aren't hardwired for normalcy. You know what I mean? They're usually whack balls that don't know how to sit in a fucking
I know. That's why it still doesn't mean it still doesn't make it any better.
Yeah.
Like, don't, you don't also, have to trick people.
Yeah.
Some people do.
It's fake. It's kind of fake confidence, too, in a way.
Yeah.
Well, you're putting a costume on.
Well, just what doing happens, it, what just if, doing it makes it seem like you're courageous.
Yeah.
When you definitely aren't.
Might be energy you could put to other things that would get a similar result.
Yeah,
rather than tricking girls. Because it is like...
Yeah, learning Spanish.
Yeah. Yeah. I mean, there is. I think this stuff works too, though.
Oh,
if you like wear...
Fuck.
I think if you wear a feather on your head and you like make eye contact with a girl for more than 10 seconds, I think she will blow you. That's why it's not... That's not nice to do.
Dressed like a cavalier.
Tricking girls.
It is a trick.
No, I was just thinking about that guy.
Yeah, you look fair. Let's get out of here. Yeah. Like, oh,
in that day and age,
where am I?
In a totally clean white outfit.
As a woman,
outfit,
you'd be
like caramel shoes.
Wet, wondering what he does.
Yeah.
How to get here.
Oh, dressed
like a cavalier.
Yeah, dressed like a prince.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Just top clanging fantasy. Into a fucking saloon. You know what I mean?
That's her top fantasy. Yeah.
Prince. God, tell me a story about a ship.
Like a royal? They love that shit.
Yeah, being a royal.
That's the ultimate, dude. That's the ultimate.
Mustache smelling like old wood. Just getting fingered by a dude with one glove on.
He's like, I have to have an important conversation with my father.
Yeah. Imagine him just taking just one glove off to sexually.
Yeah, that'd be, it's like a nice buildup.
Yeah.
Mice and men.
Really?
Guy kept his glove on for his wife. Yeah. And then he fucking squeezed her to death.
Yeah.
he couldn't finger her anymore.
Wait, he kept a glove on?
He kept a glove on for his wife in Mice and Men.
Oh.
And yeah, Mice and Men.
So that his hand was clean when he fingered?
Nice soft hand for his wife.
Oh, that's nice.
Yeah.
Hmm.
It was sweet. But he was mean. He was a bad guy.
Uh-huh.
He was mean to Lenny. Lenny fucked him up.
Yeah.
And then Lenny squeezed his wife.
Anaconda
squeeze.
Didn't he kill him in the hay? In the barn?
Yeah.
Damn, dude.
He was squeezing puppies. She found the puppies.
It was like dead rabbits in there and then on top of her.
They're like, who did this?
Yeah. Why was he doing it? They say
no, not Lenny. Lenny's mice.
Lenny's
but who's
the waterhead.
Guy?
George.
Pet the puppy,
yeah, George must have been in there.
The puppy,
he saw the pile of fucking puppies. Yeah. He's like, I know who did this. I know for sure who did this.
Oh, there's a serial squeezer out there.
It's a big squeezer. I hang out with I told you that we called the special needs people at Westchester the squeezers.
Who said that?
Me and my buddy. Because we used to go to the cafeteria. We're the only dudes in my group of friends that enjoyed the Westchester cafeteria. Because it was like, first off, it was all you can
eat.
It's the cheapest one. Yeah. It's the worst food by far, but it was the cheapest one.
Yeah, but like four different cereals on deck, dude.
It was so nice.
It was crazy.
But me and Tommy would go get lunch. And then one day the squeezers would get lunch at the same time as us.
Yeah, yeah.
There's this group of special needs people. And one day this girl grabbed the ketchup and went and fucking, dude, it hit the ceiling. I'm not kidding. The ketchup was on the ceiling.
Oh my God.
It exploded at the table. All the fucking people.
The
ketchup drone strike.
Dude, she squeezed it, ceiling and everyone at the table.
Holy
it was,
shit.
I'll never forget how happy I was, dude. The squeezers are here, dude.
What did the bros say when they got hit with ketchup?
It was startling, and the chaperone had to be like, everyone's all right. It's like,
it's literally code red.
It was a bomb. A bomb went off.
It's code red.
They all just sat down. They all just sat down with their fucking trays.
Dude, they probably just got changed from a previously sloppy shirt. Yes. They gotta change him again. We just got Rex out of his fucking.
They must have protocol for a condiment apocalypse.
It was one of those. It was the. You
it's
know
like,
what I mean?
It's
the,
like when a baby shits and then shits again. You're like, Jesus,
changing.
I gotta change the kid again.
You know how when ketchup
cleaning that shit off its back.
When ketchup's totally full, it still has the like seal. needle inside the cap. So that's what she squeezed through.
What?
And it just
my God.
I mean, I'm telling you, there was a giant like ceiling's this high. It was like a cafeteria. A tip, dude. It was a cafeteria. It exploded. It hit the ceiling.
Has that ever been done before?
Low ceilings. It's like two stories. It was nuts.
I didn't know that sitting, could be done. Just, luckily, there was a box of Marvin the Martian t-shirts.
Free credit cards on campus.
Oh, my God. Get him another one.
Yeah, the squeezers.
That's the best.
Squeezers.
Damn, see them all get decimated with ketchup. That's chaos.
That was also a low point for me, too. Like, sitting in that cafeteria, looking at the squeezers, being like, I was at West Point. Now I'm in this. West Point's cafeteria looks like Hogwarts. It's fucking incredible. Yeah. Now I'm in this, like, with office lighting
squeezers in Westchester,
just retarded people.
Like, oh my God.
Sorry to say retarded people. I take that back. I apologize.
Sure, I know what you mean, though, but it's, you know, that is the reality check.
It was like, Jesus Christ.
They got like 2.9 GPA.
Yeah, they're doing just as well as me.
Oh my God.
Yeah, what classes were they taking?
Fucking
math.
Gotta be some kind of metal shop and art.
They're probably getting math. They're probably getting some math going.
Some kind of metal shop. Yeah, they can get the math.
You get the math. Social studies.
Fired up. Yeah. Nice. What else is going on? How are you guys?
Pretty
What's
good.
What's going on? Yeah. What's up with Stuff Island, dude?
Stuff
you
Island.
Guys are ready to go to Italy soon, huh?
Yeah. Well, if you guys can get us 200 patrons in a week.
Yeah.
Is what I want. I want them to hit this milestone have to go to Italy.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Because I want nothing more than these two to have to go to fucking...
It's a vacation.
Monza?
To go right now, it would cost like
$50,000. They're going to lose a lot of money. They're going to lose a lot of money on this, which I'm excited about.
Yeah probably.
It's going to be...
Money's nothing.
It's everything. And it'll be the last. We'd be in deep...
So you're gonna scoop into the coffers. Trouble. You're going to scoop into the coffers.
Yeah.
An Italy trip, the flight will be probably about what? Like
$2,000?
A grand each, yeah. Oh, yeah, I guess back and forth.
I don't know. On like 4 days' notice.
You guys have to do it.
We'd have to lock it in.
At the height of the Italian Grand Prix.
We'd have to lock it in.
Oh, yeah, they're going to the Formula One. Oh, and you have to go to the Formula One. That's going to be a lot of money.
That's a $5,000.
Well, that'll just be us like peeking through from a mile away.
Why not just go and then film it and be like, hey, and then just be like, I hope it works.
Yeah.
I mean, maybe we'll get more patrons that way, but we did it anyway, you guys.
Yeah, yeah. Despite.
Fuck those 200 patrons.
Maybe that's what we should have done.
Yeah.
Tickets were cheap.
Tickets were cheap when we looked it up.
But how fast are you going to do it when you hit that number immediately?
I mean,
if we get it 10 days,
September 9th. Next day. It needs to be that
night. Is September 9th.
Yes.
No, 11th.
Oh,
right?
Nice.
It's the
11th. It's the 9th through the 11th.
Oh, no. 11th is when Eagles game. Yeah.
September 11th is the race.
Okay.
The Grand Prix.
September 9th.
So you're going to miss NFL week one, too.
Nah, I'll be watching out there at the race.
You have to go.
With a fucking beer helmet on.
That'll be good content. That was Italy.
Me motherfucking Jalen Hurts in Italy.
Where's the race?
Milan. Dirty city.
Oh, well, that's a dirty street city. Walks.
You think so?
Yeah, they're a little American hellos in Milan.
Get some unibrows.
God damn it. I'll grow my mustache out there.
Dude.
I'll make my unibrow dance for you.
There will
some other girls.
Oh, okay.
No.
I was like, I'm not offended. It's all right.
Talk about the girls.
It would be crazy.
There's Frida Kahlo's over there.
Dude, pussy to asshole.
No, they're probably beautiful.
Just eyebrows all the way
belly,
down.
Very belly button to asshole, those little fucking dark princesses.
I haven't seen a happy trail on a woman in
a while. I saw one.
15 years.
I saw one recently.
Really?
Yeah. And it had a little strip down the spine too, like the fuzzies you get as a hairy teenager. But she was 28.
And where did you see this?
What? Can we talk about it afterwards?
Where did you see it?
I'll tell you.
And you fucked this lady, this hairy thing?
Were you looking at Playboys?
No, they still make them like that.
The lowest price right now is $583.
Round trip.
Nothing.
In a to Milan? Kitchen coupe.
JFK to Milan nonstop. $583.
Ooh, all right. That's not bad.
Then it jumps to 1,000. The next flights.
What time are we leaving? Like, that's a red eye.
No, it's 5 p.m. You arrive at 7 a.m. Yeah.
Yeah, it's pretty good. Yeah,
that'd be
fucking
great.
Incredible.
That'd be perfect.
And we can actually sleep.
Not bad.
Well, I won't, but
you guys got to go.
I think we should go.
Just go to Italy. Milan. Go to Italy for 4 days.
Please just sign up for the paycheck anyway.
Yeah.
Please, no, things are good, man. Things are great.
Tickets to the Grand Prix are
$3,000.
You said we could get in that documentary thing.
Oh yeah, Chris, you got some
maybe,
hookups.
Maybe.
What are their names? Maybe.
Yeah, exactly.
Maybe.
Burn your bridge. Call me. Who are your best friends?
Maybe. Jesse Lee Peterson's going to have you on the road.
Jesse Lee, what if the debate's during that?
The debate would be the day before, I think.
Is it really? And you flee the country?
What? So. It's not a debate, by the way. I don't
Dude,
know.
Just move the date.
What do you think you guys are going to talk about?
I don't know. He's just going to hammer me with questions. Dude, it's like a deposition.
How does he even know who you are?
I don't know.
The internet, dude.
I assume you saw me on Matt and Shane's podcast, or someone saw, and like they were giving me the business, and they were like, "This looks
someone,
like a,
there's a good chance a someone good might mark. Have fed. Someone might have fed.
Yeah,
the
I
DOS.
Would imagine somebody fed him like, hey, there's a top Democrat thing. I mean,
oh my God. I can't wait.
Yeah.
To get a corner, get a bunch of people there fact checking on the ground.
He's
going
to call
debating.
Me a child of the lie.
Is he?
Yeah, that's what they call. That's what he calls.
Call him a child of the molester.
Liberals are children of the lie.
You should be like, well, then you want to fuck me, right? You fucking weirdo. That's good. You can hit him with molestation charges. Yeah,
yeah. I'm just going to sit by in the waiting room like this.
Allegedly, obviously, allegedly. There is one documentary I've didn't watch 10 minutes person. While I was taking a dump, and I was done taking a dump, and I stopped. But yeah, again, we're fucking.
They
around,
do that to powerful black men. They
What's
hit him with those types of allegations a lot.
Jesse Lee Peterson. People are alleging. Let's be clear for the record. People are alleging. That he's indeed gay, although he's been pretty active against.
You can be gay, but if you fuck my boy over, I'll beat your ass.
But he's saying
yes.
Well, he's out for blood.
He would
bro.
Fucking one punch you, dude.
Yeah, he's out for blood.
Well, the reason, yeah.
But he, dude, people are saying up? That he's a sexual predator against young.
Yeah,
men.
Yeah.
People are saying that. That's been said.
I heard a wild
in a
story.
30-minute YouTube video.
Yeah.
There's that story interviews. You told me upstairs. Well, we can't talk about it, but that was fucked up.
Oh, yeah. Sorry. Jesus Christ.
I know. I just thought of it.
Redacted. Yeah. Cut that. Where are we at time wise, Sean? Let's do some ads real quick.
Oh, yeah.
We got some big ads today, dude. This was a huge, huge fucking get.
Show
dude.
that fucking pipe, dude. It's unbelievable.
Dude. Yo, dude, that's my fucking tiny penis. Get off
yeah,
it.
That's the problem with white. You can see all the nutty
True.
Penis.
You can see all. Oh, dude. So pleased. Thank you, Hamilton Devices, for sponsoring the shows. Innovators in vape tech. Matt, talk about what they sent you. Dude, first of all, this is what...
I'm sorry.
Oh, that's got like an extension cable. Like
check this out. This is one of the things
like
they
did
sent
you work
us.
At Google and your key dude, card?
Yeah.
With
yeah.
the phone so the camera can see it.
Oh, so this is... Let me tell you how good this product is.
You got to move the mic a little.
So this is like high stealth. So if you're like somewhere where you're like an IT guy and you're carrying around weird equipment, you could attach your vape to it, bring it to your face when your boss isn't looking, and just go.
Wow.
And people, what the hell was that smell? And you just put this little thing back up.
Come back saying like a little.
You go, nothing. And they never be able to tell.
Yeah, they can never see this.
Or this one, the Sherlock pipe.
Hey, move your hand so they can see the pipe.
The pipe is sick, dude.
That is nice.
Interesting point.
Interesting
point.
Thing is. Interesting, Jesse Lee Peterson.
Oh, shit.
Dude, you're going to be.
It's going to be a good picture. Yeah. It's going to be a good drive home.
On the but page. I think girls can have penises.
Let me see that pipe.
Well, did you molest a boy?
Yeah. Ah, wow.
That is sick.
It's got a cool shark on it. Did you ever see the shark on there?
I did. That's Hamilton Device's logo. They also did a thing. I don't have it with That's me, sadly. Nice. Although it makes me, it's you screw three vape cartridges into one thing. It's called the Starship. Oh, yeah. I gave it to Lemaire. So Lemaire put a video. Lemaire did a video. We'll interject a quick video of Lemaire hitting the Starship.
Well, I got it.
So guys, I don't even know why they write. Let me write the fucking copy. So the Starship vape will send you straight to outer space. That's the thing I'm talking about. It's small and discreet like a vape pen, but hits hard like a dab. And they make a hands-free vape called the Garner. Wear it, vape it, charge Christ, it all at the same time.
No way.
They even have vapes that Please. Look like old-timey tobacco pipes. That one. Go to HamiltonDevices.com. Use code DRENCHED15 for 15% off. Buyers must be 21 or older. Not available in Vermont, Kentucky, Oregon, or Belize. That's HamiltonDevices.com. Use code DRENCHED15 for 15% off.
Belize?
Sorry, Belize.
No.
Yeah.
Not here. I don't want them dropping all the waterfalls and stuff.
Also, if you guys have been looking for an alternative to smoking, why not switch to a nicotine product that you can feel good about? Check out all that Lucy has to offer at lucy.co. That's lucy.co. No, lucy.co. Use promo code DRENCHED at checkout. If you're a listener from Canada, you can now get Lucy at ca.lucy.co. China. Warning, this product contains nicotine. Nicotine is an addictive chemical, but if you're interested in a better way to use nicotine, visit lucy.co and be sure to use that promo code.
This drenched. Is made by Lucy too?
No.
Oh. Is it
Hamilton Devices?
Weren't you
Hamilton.
Listening?
That's yeah. Hamilton Do Devices, it over. Dude. No way. They only get one. But yeah, Lucy for the chews for nicotine stuff.
Yeah.
Guys, but then when you're vaping, you've had all the nicotine, you get your fill of nicotine and vapes, you need to look at a hot babe on a magnetic poster.
Oh, that'd be
guys.
So sick to look
guys,
at.
Guys, DISPLATE is a one-of-a-kind metal poster that only takes 20 seconds to install.
Dude, you're, just install it.
Dude, it takes 20 seconds.
Fucking seconds.
Shane, your poster comes with a magnetic sticker.
You got, those are yours?
You got DISPLATE.
Yeah. Oh, look at that. The where, dog, let me see
oh,
that.
Hold that. Bring that up. Yeah, we're actually supposed to have
bring
that in
both.
The shop.
I've got a cow and a pig. I'm going to put them in there for look at this.
Yeah, so if you're a DISPLATE... Oh, you're in a... Okay, there we go.
Wow.
Yeah, guys, bring that DISPLATE up, guys. So you could try to hang it to a frame or whatever into the wall, but or you just
looks
glue
like somebody
a magnet.
We know.
Look at that. You just, what'd you say?
So it looks like somebody we know.
So, oh, yeah, it does!
You could...
look at that.
You could just hang that to your wall with magnets. It's
you can hang this
cool.
in your kitchen.
No power tools, no wall damage. You can easily switch it out for a new poster, too.
Tells you what to do with each
They have millions of designs available and officially licensed designs from Star Wars, Netflix, Call of Duty, and more. Check the link in our description to see some of our favorites and get your own sexy lady.
Tommy, save you time. Are... Tommy is just a dad. Like, somebody gave him a free thing. He's like, look at that. That thing, it's pretty nice. Oh, it shows you how to cut.
Did you
thing.
Know about that kind of meat?
This
I never
is,
heard of that.
I think this is very interesting, to be honest.
Click, save 25% if you buy one
I
or two.
Brisket
and get 29% off when you buy three or more DISPLATES. The discount will be automatically applied to your cart when you click our link. Use code DRENCHED when you visit DISPLATE.com to get the discount. That's DISPLATE.com, code DRENCHED, or to click the link in our show notes. So you can have your very own
you have something like this.
Steak diagram. I've one of chickens. It's pretty good. It's thighs, wings.
I like thighs.
Breasts. Damn. Man, what a slog. There was three ads, man.
That was. You I did was. Great, though.
We're a hot commodity, dude. We might have to raise the rates, bro.
Yeah.
Well, dude, man, let's do this all in one. How about that?
Yeah.
We should have did with
rates just doubled. Actually, we work exclusively for Hamilton Devices.
Yeah,
that thing is wild.
Have you hit that a lot before?
No, the way
I don't know how strong this thing is.
Oh, this I know the vape. This is my vape cartridge.
Oh,
they fucking get you.
Okay,
this is souls and blood, dude. You hit too many of these, it's blood and souls.
It's time to write a letter to your sister.
Did you drive up?
Yeah,
you can you drive high? It doesn't matter, right?
Yeah. No, I'll sober up. I sober up very quickly though.
Yeah, you
like
lying.
As soon as I get into my car. It's
yeah, I get it. Good to go. That's what I do.
Guardian, you hitting that Sherlock? Nice.
How do you feel? Great. You tripping, man?
So what else is going on, guys? What's going on? What's like, you know, in your,
I got
like, your
a big
most
week.
Intimate
got a big
life?
Week coming up. I
Chained us,
didn't
yeah.
know I was booked in Chicago.
What?
I am at the Chicago Improv this weekend. And then go to Austin.
Yeah, you thought you had a week off.
Yeah, then I go to Austin for a couple of days, then I fly up to Columbus, dude, for Notre Dame.
Oh yeah, Notre Dame, Ohio
State.
Oh,
the opener.
Yes, and then a week later, I go to Vegas for Diaz. Can't wait.
That's awesome.
Can't wait. There's high potential for negative. You know, both my teams are pretty big underdogs, but if they can just pull it out, one of them.
Telling you,
I would honestly. This is crazy. This is the first time in my life I would take Notre Dame losing and Nate winning.
For yeah, I mean,
sure.
It's dude's life.
Winning,
you had to choose.
Nate winning would be the coolest thing in the fucking world.
Of course.
Yeah, that would be.
And there, it's going to be.
And watching that Edwards fight gives me hope.
Dude.
I know Khamzat is going to wrestle and fight. He probably has more power. I don't know.
Are you sitting behind Joe again?
Yeah.
That's so funny. Be,
bro, but I'm telling you, Nate, first of all, the fact that he's doing it is admirable. Win or lose.
The fucking best.
It's unbelievable. But if he fucking, I'd be so happy if he wins.
If he
and
does
dude,
it.
It's He's taken down greats before.
I bet he's going to be like you in Chicago. He's probably like, oh shit, I didn't know how to fight this week. Let's get fucking
dude, he's
overrun.
Done damage to greats.
Yeah.
So I don't know, man.
Have you spoken to him at all? Is he training extra hard?
No, I haven't spoken to him.
Yeah.
I've talked to his friends.
I bet you that's just, what the corners say.
Yeah, those dudes, what? They're never not training.
Yeah.
That's how he was able to take the McGregor fight on 11 days notice. He was just like, I'm just training.
all the time.
He's doing triathlons and always.
Holy shit. Even just doing jiu-jitsu, dude, it's like when you do that 3 days a week, you're like an Olympic athlete. In terms of like the caloric output.
He does jiu-jitsu and triathlons all.
That's like crazy. Just triathlon shit is like, that's fucking crazy. Nuts.
I jogged a mile today and I was like, that's decent. Yeah. I didn't take a break through the mile. I was like, wow, pretty good.
That's really good.
Yeah. I was fucking pumped. How long? How 10 fast? Minute mile? 10
that's
minute mile, bro.
Fucking great.
Call me the Kenyan. That's pretty fucking
10
good.
Minute miles. Bro, hey, that's nothing to fucking sneeze
fucking
at.
Bird in the sidewalk.
You can fight. You're on 11 days notice, dude. You're in shape. You're in fighting shape.
I had to fuel up today. I got out of my car. I was wearing this so I didn't forget it. So I wore it out of my house. I went to fuel up. I was like up in Kensington.
You wore that on the jog?
I was driving. No, not on the jog. I wish. I probably would have got like a 9 minute mile. Dude, I get out of my car. I get out of my car and I specifically was looking for a gas station that I could use Apple Pay because I forgot my wallet. So I wonder what. And I'm like, so I get out.
Fuck, I forgot my wallet.
Literally, I was like, don't too far. So I get out. And there's a guy, he's like, if I had to guess what he was like a homeless crackhead. I don't know if the guy, I think he probably smoked crack, didn't have a house, sit outside the gas station on a pipe. He was asking people for money. I pop out, pay with my phone at the pump, have my vape on my lanyard, and I like send a text on my watch. I'm like this, and like he like looked
You're
at me.
You're astronaut.
He looked future, at me, looked away. Dude, I'm telling you, like, this guy probably thinks I'm from the future.
And that was future
he fully
shit.
Didn't ask me, and he asked the next guy, he's like, can I get a dollar? Yeah. He looked at me and went like, I don't even know.
What is that?
Yeah. What the fuck is
this
going
hologram on? Hologram is in my fucking way.
That was a hologram, fine. Yes. Just beep onto the thing with my phone, have my lanyard. He's like, that made smoke? This thing produces smoke? And then fucking boom, talk to my watch, and he's like, this guy is a Jetson.
Dude, I cannot do the dictation thing at all.
Really?
Yeah. It never works.
Yeah, that's the point. Scream. I send someone an incoherent long message that you talk and they have to like, what the fuck?
Just throw them off the trail for a while.
Yeah, you just send someone explanation of why you're late. And you're just like
just random
I
words.
I can't slow down speed.
So it finally
Strolls.
Happened. He finally broke. This is it. He's supposed to be here today. He sent me a paragraph of gibberish. Yeah.
I got to use your potty.
All right, let's switch over to Patreon.
Guys,
join the Patreon.
Yes,
so you can listen to the rest of the conversation. These guys are going to be high. That'll be fun.
Yeah, true. Did you smoke?
No.
Oh.